Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dutch Sea Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. And I've got me a box from Hey Boxing, or HBX. You probably know it mostly as HBX, especially if you are into RC cars, which is in this box. A race truck. Well, it's actually the 18859 Rampage. The box doesn't say Rampage, but it's nevertheless, it's called the Rampage. You might actually be familiar with the 18859 from HBX. However, this is a new version, the 2020 or 2021 version, if you will. During the course of this video, I'll point out a couple of differences from this new version to the previous one. And they are all improvements, which is nice. So I'll be doing several videos on this car. In this video, I'm going to show you what you get for your money if you order it. Point of note, I got me this car from HBX free of charge, and the link in the description is not an affiliate link, so I'm not making any money with this video, just so you know. So this will be an unbiased review of the content of this here box. So at the top of our box we've got a drawing or a schematic of our car, the car number or product number, and also this product is not a toy. Well, guess what? It is a toy. Yeah, it is a monster truck, an RC car, and a 1/18 scale 4x4 car at that. And at this side of the box says RTR, and that's mostly true. You do get a transmitter and running lipos, but you do need batteries for the transmitter. Other than that, it is truly an RTR. Four-wheel drive, 2.4 gigahertz, of course. Actual springs, ball bearings, and this is a brushed car, and we'll see in running videos if that's nice or not. I have actually had HBX cars which were brushed, a lot of fun, and obviously a brushless car would be faster, but we'll see how this one fares with its brushed setup. And waterproof, let's call this car splash proof. You wouldn't be driving this car through water in a lake, for instance, obviously. But in rain and through puddles, you should be okay with this car. Over here, we've got some more product pictures. The car is actually available with a green shell, an orange shell, a blue one, and a red one, as you can see here. I actually have several bodies, so I can show you a couple of colors in this video. All right, with that said, let's actually take this car out of the box. There you go. Hopefully you can see that the car is well protected in this box. No damage whatsoever. The shell is already in place. You know what? I'll take the packaging off so we can more clearly see what we have here. Hartstikke idee, we have ourselves a 1/18 scale HBX car. Four-wheel drive monster truck. I think this is a monster truck. This is obviously the blue shell or the blue themed shell. And one thing you should notice is that there's no text, no decals on it whatsoever, which is nice, I think. A lot of these Chinese brands deliver us shells with all kinds of text, sometimes with writing mistakes or bad English or whatever. I'm glad to see that you get the shell without any decals. You can add decals to your liking. Speaking of, you actually get a decal sheet with this car, which is nicer than, well, expected. You get two versions of the grille, whichever you like. You get headlights, but also different headlights, different tail lights, and some other graphics you can add to your liking. In a second I'll show you a shell with some decals on it, but it's nice that they, well, leave you the choice of a couple of different styles. Right? I haven't actually seen this much in Proline shells. Proline shells often come with different styles of graphics, but very, very nice. Before you go and add your decals, be sure to peel off the protective film. There's a thin layer of film on this shell. Might not be apparent and it's hard to get out of, but
try peeling it off from one of the corners of the shell, like so. See? Just as long as you've got this yellow sticker on the shell, you shouldn't be applying the decals. And this is obviously for shipping and painting of the shell to protect it. More on the car in a second. Let's take a closer look in a second. But you also get a transmitter. A 2.4 GHz transmitter, obviously, and it's pretty basic. I have to tell you, it's pretty basic. For instance, the steering wheel is all plastic. It feels okay, it isn't bouncy, but there's no rubber on it or foam padding. So it is a bit basic. It's got an on-off switch over here, steering trim, obviously a throttle, and the feel of the throttle is pretty okay actually. Actually, the entire feel of the transmitter is pretty okay. It's comfortable in the hand. Okay, and at the top of our transmitter you've got a steering reverse and also a slow and higher speed or normal speed switch. So with that you can hand the transmitter to younger children maybe, set it to slow, like so. And you'll end up with a slower car for younger kids. And in my driving video I'll show you what the actual difference is. And there's no other buttons or switches on this transmitter. It's nice to see that the aerial or the antenna isn't a flimsy one that can easily break off. So, and well, what do you say about the looks of the transmitter? It looks okay, I think. But we'll see how it works. I'm sure it'll work for line of sight driving, right? But we'll see. You also get a metal wheel wrench, which is nice. But the weird thing actually is that the wheels are screwed on, and we'll take a closer look at it in a second, what the wheel adapters are. But okay, to work on your car, I'm not even sure if it's useful at all. But it's always nice to get a metal wrench, thank you very much. We get ourselves a care package. Let's actually see. This car should come with two LiPos, and I think the second one is already in the car. This is actually an upgrade from the previous version of this car. This is an 850 mAh 2S, and the old version of this car came with a 650 mAh 2S LiPo. It's got a Deans connector, which might be a bit, well, old school. It'll work for cars, of course. You also get a USB charger, which will probably work out fine for this car. It's well, something to get you started. Eventually you will opt to get an actual hobby grade charger, but this will get you started. You get an extra set of body clips, which is highly appreciated. And we get a manual. Proper manual actually. Yeah, proper English. And there's a lot of information on the everything you basically need to know in several languages. And what are those languages? English. I've seen German, yeah, German, French. Probably not Dutch, no. Okay, English, German and French. And we've got a parts list, exploded views. Yeah. Also exploded fuse for the car. Excellent, looks very nice. And with that guys, let's take a closer look at the car itself. So if you have seen the old version of the 18859 and you want to know what's different about this one, you can recognize the newer versions on their tires mostly. The old versions had a chevron-like pattern on them. I'll show you a picture of the old tires. The car is very similar, but still everything is revised in this new version. So we've got a canopy. Again, it's available in four colors. I will link one of the versions in the description down below, and I'll also post up a couple of links, the brand itself and a link to Banggood. Have a look. I think the link at Banggood is still showing the old version. So from that link you can also see what the old version looks like. And the canopy has clear windows,
which I very much appreciate. I never like RC cars with closed up windows. Traxxas cars, I'm not gonna knock on Traxxas cars, they make great cars, as you probably know, but a lot of their canopies have closed up windows. It's due to their manufacturing process, but I don't really like it. Oh well, so the body, you saw that I had had me four spare body clips, right? But they have plastic tabs on them. And I very much appreciate that as well. Right? A lot of these body clips come without a tab. So that's nice. And the body is held on with four clips. And then you take the Lexan body right off. Comes off very easily. And hopefully you can also see at the front over here some wires. This car has LED lights. Very nice. And I'll show you what those look like in a second, of course. I must say, I very much like the looks of these tires. They should provide us with some much needed grip. The tires, however, are completely empty. There's no foam lining in these tires. That is a bit of a shame. And that, yeah, the car isn't expensive, but that would have been a nice upgrade. In a second, we'll take a look at what the mounting pattern or the mounting method of these wheels are. So maybe you can upgrade the wheels. That's also always a nice option. And I am happy to show you that indeed there is already a battery in the car. So with that, you get the car with two batteries, which is nice. The original version also came with two batteries, but smaller batteries. And over here, we see a combined ESC and receiver. And that splits out to the servo over here, the steering servo, which is on the other side. Probably a plastic geared servo. And it is the kind of servo that has five leads on it. So you can't just go ahead and replace that steering servo with any hobby grade steering servo. That is, however, pretty common for RC cars in this price range. And with that said, the question comes to mind whether this is a toy grade car or a hobby grade car. And I think it's somewhere in between. Well, mostly it leans to hobby grade. Most, if not all, the parts are rebuildable and replaceable. For instance, these shocks are pretty standard size shocks, and you can upgrade them with, a lot of options in shocks. So these shocks are, as you can tell, very springy, bouncy. They are definitely not oil filled. And I'd go as far to say that these shocks will not hold oil. The spring rate is adjustable though, with these blue colors. You can see the blue colors. You can twist them down and extend or retract these springs, making them harder or softer. So that's nice. You can also extend these body posts, front and back. Yeah, these are adjustable body posts, so that's nice. You can, upgrade the body or change the body to a different style. That's nice. Also over here, you see the brushed, non-rebuildable can motor. This is a 380 size motor, I think. And that motor has heat dissipating ribs over here, as you can tell. Okay, so the entire car is basically plastic, right? And for instance, these bumpers. Well, actually pretty nice. Not too stiff and not too flimsy. This feels actually pretty okay. Very nice. Other than that, this entire chassis is very reminiscent of buggy layouts. You've got a battery on one side, motor on the other side. Then you've got an ESC and a steering servo. A pretty typical setup, right? And with that said, let's take two wheels off so we can have a good look at our suspension. There you go, two wheels off. And as you can tell, pretty typical 12 millimeter hexes, and the wheels were held on with screws. So there's no metal bolts and a nut at the end, which is typical. However, this setup allows us to use all kinds of aftermarket wheels and tires, which is nice. You can definitely upgrade this car to your liking. The hexes were kind of pressed into the wheels, as you can tell, but you can, they are plastic hexes, and you can can take them out, and you can even replace them with metal hexes if you prefer that. Taking a look at the front suspension then, we've got a plastic A-arm at the bottom and a plastic A-arm at the top, and they are non-adjustable, as you can tell. Also, there are no alternate shock mounting positions, bottom and top, so this is what you get, basically. Is that true? No, you actually have two positions to mount the shocks at the top. At the bottom, there's one. We do have metal dog bones, yeah, for our driveline. And also, it's very hard to show you, but there's a metal drive shaft from the front to the back of the car. So basically, the entire drive line is metal. And do we have differentials? We do have a front differential, a rear differential. I don't think there's a center diff. The car is, however, four-wheel drive. Also, what you can see over here now is a little on-off button. It's not a switch, it's an on-off button. You hold on to that button for a couple of seconds and that turns the car on or off, like so. Now the car's on. I don't have the transmitter on, but that's pretty easy. And you can, well, you can get to it with the body on, and even with gloves on, you should be able to operate that switch. Very neat. And at the rear of a car, the suspension is pretty much the same. Obviously not steerable, and the A-arms below and top are not identical front to back of the car. From the looks of it, is that true? Yeah, they're not identical, but the setup is pretty much the same. And at the rear, we do have four mounting points for the shocks, two on top and two at the bottom. And again, we've got a metal drive shaft, a dog bone at the rear over here. A look at the bottom of our car then, which is pretty much sealed off at the bottom, so there's not a whole lot of chance to get dirt into the top. After a while, obviously, everything will get dirty, but I'm glad to see there are no holes or anything in the center top section of our chassis. And all screws on this car are again Phillips head screwed, so again, I'm not completely sure why we got a hex wrench with the car. The car should have come with a Phillips head screwdriver, but that's a minor thing, of course. But yeah, I've checked, and I think again that all screws on the entire car are Phillips head screws, and they actually look pretty much the same, or maybe two sizes, so you can get away with two Phillips head drivers. Of course, be mindful that you are mostly screwing into plastic, so don't strip out things, of course, but that's the same with Phillips head as on hex head screwdrivers. Okay, so actually let's have a look at the car with the LED lights on. This is, by the way, also one of the shells with some decals on, as you can tell. Very, very nice. And again, you can pick and choose what decals you want to apply or don't want to apply to your liking. And then I should be able to just reach around to the on-off button. There, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see the LEDs. There are only front LEDs, so there's no rear LEDs. And once the car is bound to your radio, they won't be blinking, of course, but they are pretty bright, actually. Let me turn down the lighting a little. Pretty nice, and they are definitely bright enough to be visible in daylight. And that's, well, that's true with modern LEDs, of course, so very nice. Always a nice addition to have LEDs on our car, so I'm happy to see that on this RTR HBX car. Very, very nice. And with that said, that was our first look at the HBX or Hiboxing 18859, a 2020 version of this 118 scale monster truck. Tell me in the comment section below what you think. Obviously, I'll be doing running videos with this car coming up shortly, weather permitting. It's winter in the Netherlands, in case you are wondering. So yeah, again, I'll bust out some running videos just as soon as I can. Be on the lookout for that. For now, I want to thank you for watching. Catch you on the next video. Bye-bye.